All right, Scott the Wall. Hey, we would like to start off by giving our honor and glory to Yahweh Bashem, Yahweh Shah, Bashem, Papa Dash, double honor star, possibly great meal, Snow Ruel. Peace and blessings to the house of David the elect, all right? You going to an open forum?
Yes, today's just an open forum. Don't let a Yash kick it off.
Yeah, so, you know, what we're going to get into, you know, as the latest, all right, dealing with our people, man, because at the end of the day, when you go into the gospel, all right, it was for a certain nation of people, you know, so-called Negroes, Latinos, Americans, man. All right, when you go into the Bible, it's about the history, the legacy of this certain people, man. You know, how we fell from greatness. And now we see the condition of our people and we compare it to what was said in the scriptures. And that's how we know who we are, man. You see, look at the condition of Jake, man. You know, it's time for the Lord to shut this place down, man. You know, because our people just going to get worse and worse and worse, man. You got to know where a nigga will kill another nigga over $4 chicken sandwich, man. Right. All these restaurants, all right, they serve chicken sandwiches. All these grocery stores, you can go grill. You got 1,000 options within Babylon to get a chicken sandwich, but you die, all right, over a low budget, all right, GMO, all right, chicken sandwich, you know, in Popeye, man. You know?
With $200 shoes on.
Yeah. Right. You know? Yeah. Brother, get Lamentations 4 and 2.
I got one for you.
Yeah.
Lamentations 2:15. All that pass by clap their hands.
Yeah.
At thee. Mm-hmm. They hiss and wag their head at the daughter of Jerusalem.
Hey, the daughter of Jerusalem, man. Speaking about the whole nation, man. All right. Go ahead, bro.
Saying, is this the city that men call the perfection of beauty? The joy of the whole earth.
Because you got us out there professing, because that happened during the time, all right, of the Southern Kingdom, when the Babylonians came in and conquered them, man. Uh-huh. You know, because the Southern Kingdom, all right, going to Judah, Benjamin, and Levi, all right, they were the kingdom where you had the Messiah, Yahweh Shah would come out of, you had Solomon, King David, the great kings and great warriors and prophets, you know, dealing with the priests, you know, but now, they was esteemed as nothing during the time when the Babylonians came and took them down and all the nations round about seen it. But now, you fast forward to this time, look at our people at this time, man. It's even way worse than then. And we out there every week confessing who we are, brothers going to books, brothers going to documentary, doing research, confessing who we are. And then you have a nigga kill another nigga with chicken sandwich. You know them Edomites like, and these are the Lord's people.
Yeah,
right. These niggas, I knew they were just some niggas, man.
Yeah. It's the local news now. Yeah. Their scripture is manifested now through the local and world news.
Yeah.
You know, you're sitting here literally watching the news until you're eating my family. Right
there. Hey, yo, man. All thy enemies have opened their mouth against thee.
Mm-hmm.
They hiss and master teeth. They say, we have swallowed her up. Certainly, this is the day that we look for. We have found, we have seen it.
And we have seen it. Hey, you can look on the comment boards, man. That's the anytime a nigga do something dumb, look at the comment boards, look at other nations' perspective of so-called black and Hispanics, man. All right, but also it's the elites rejoicing that they conquered a nation, man.
Yeah, cause what, 5 Edomites that own Popeye?
Yeah, I don't know.
I think it's 5 Edomites, you know, men and women, you know, that have a joint venture with them Popeyes, man.
Mm.
You know, do you think they eat Popeyes, people that own them, man?
Yeah. But that's a term in business, like, don't eat your dog food.
Yeah.
Like, don't consume what you sell, you know?
Right.
You know?
And this is Zephaniah 2:1. Gather yourselves together. Yeah, gather together, O nation not desired.
And who is the nation not desired? So-called Negro, Latino, and Native American, man.
Yeah.
Who are they telling go back to Africa? Who are they telling go back to Mexico, man? All right? Who are they mocking, all right, with these sports teams, the Atlanta Braves, the Redskins, all right? Who they mocking, man? They mocking the Israelites, man.
Mm-hmm.
You not want it, man. You know,
you got to think about when you go to these inner cities, like in any city you go to, you always got like the low level restaurants,
mm-hmm,
or the liquor stores. You know what I'm saying? Or you never ask yourself, like, why don't you see no Whole Foods in this area, mm-hmm, in the city? You know what, mm-hmm, I'm saying? When you go into across those tracks and you go to like in the so-called uppity area, you'll see Whole Foods, mm-hmm, you'll see all these high end restaurants, things that such. God is systematically designed because they know who we are, man.
Right.
You know, just our people don't know That's why it says that Israel do not consider, man. You know?
But like with every city, they in a particular area. Like you say, it's systematically designed. No matter where you at, it's a black side of town. It's a nigga side of town where they got low level shit, and that's where Georgia and Jake be, you know what I'm saying? That's where they can only survive because that's how they got this shit set up. They bill, they EBT, and all that shit, even the grocery store.
And if you, and this is, I know y'all holding the scripture, you know, bring up this point, man. And even when you go to the better side of town, man, you look at all those service restaurants, man, it's always Jake in the kitchen. The Southern and Northern Kingdom. No matter how upkept that environment is, it's Jake in the kitchen. So Esau sets you up to only make minimum wage, $8, $9, $10 an hour. You can only afford to poison yourself, man.
And like in this, like in Mississippi, we got like these uppity cities called Madison and Flowood. Like after what, I want to say 9, 10 o'clock on the weekday, they shut down all their restaurants, right? When you go down to the hoods or whatever, the so-called black side of the city, you're going to see IHOP open, Mickey D's, Crystals, Rallies.
Burger King.
Yeah, Rallies, Burger King. You'll see them open, man.
I'm on sale 24 hours.
Yeah, that's true.
Mm-hmm. And then Jake's slaves.
Yeah.
Jake is a slave. Yeah. You know, you wonder why they got an attitude. They might be uptight. Mm-hmm. That sure do got an attitude. But they, like, you work at Walmart, you're a slave, you're man.
Crazy, man.
They depersonal, how you say it, dehumanize you.
Right.
Take your spirit away from you, just a zombie up there, you man.
Legs and feet.
Yep.
So Jake working those graveyard shifts, and those are the only things, restaurants that's open, you know what I'm saying? And that's the thing, that they keep consuming those type of foods, and they just send up toxins in your body.
Yeah, because you out late, 11 o'clock, and you're getting a 4 for 4.
Yep.
What? Think about how this process in your digestive tract, man.
Yeah, and it's not. And that's why we have the term called visceral fat, because it's fat within your abdomen region. And the only way to get that out of you is basically cardio, okay, and like an extensive workout. So what does that visceral fat promote? High cholesterol, man. Right.
Which is basically mucus.
Yes, that's all it is.
It's called like a plaque.
Yeah.
Yep.
No, it's mucus, it's plaque. Yeah. So what happens when you got plaque in your arteries, man?
That's right, bro.
You got no circulation, man. That's why you 37 and have a heart attack on the job, man. That's why you got low, poor blood circulation. You can't get your thing up, man.
Yeah. You should not have ED at 25 or 26.
Yeah, man.
We had a so-called cousin, the bitch passed out. She's like 34, died of a heart attack. Why? Because she was obese, man.
34
years old, man. Extremely young, man. You know, but why is the reason that? Why are we here? Well, get that Ruth 1 and 20 real fast.
It's Ruth 1 and 20.
Uh-huh.
And she said to him, call me now, Naomi.
Right. And this is Naomi. We talked about in the book of Ruth, okay? Go ahead, bro.
Call me Mara.
Call me who?
Mara.
Go ahead.
For the Almighty had dealt very bitterly with me.
Right. And if you can receive this in the spirit, this is where you get America from. From the origin of, get that origin, bro. I want to say it's Moab.
First Kings
4:21. Hold on, bro. I want to say it's Moab. Oh, right? It's Salakia. Yeah. Moab. That's where you get America from. Okay, this is the origin of America. So the reason why the 12 tribes came over here is why? Because the Most High has done bitterly with us, man. Why? Because basically we have to finish off them curses, man.
You can feel it.
All right, this is the last leg of the curses, so we have to come over here. You didn't come over here to thrive and things of that nature or to enjoy the fatness of the earth. No, you came over here to finish out your captivity, man. Now, if the Most High bless you with some crumbs and so on and so forth, okay, you use the world and not abuse the world, but at the same time frame, America is not our continuing city, man.
Okay. You can see it, man. You know, and we did 11:4:1. We cover, man. But we're gonna show you what the prophecies say about our people, and we're gonna show you where we fail from, man. That's another thing why people have how they just keep falling so low, because they don't understand the legacy of where we come from, man. Come you on. See, all they understand is what Esau has fabricated them. See, it everything looks like an upgrade from the cotton fields getting your back beat. You know, so anything else after that look like an upgrade, man. But really, you will destroy yourself more and more, man. You know?
Go ahead, bro.
It says Lamentation 4:1.
Start 2.
Well, you start 1. Come on. It says, how is the gold become dim?
Yep.
How is the most fine gold changed?
And we are that fine gold. Come. You know, because Yahweh Shemashah made Israel as a peculiar nation to himself, man. You know, because you got to think, the Most High is a king. You know, he doesn't deal with just anything. You know, he going to deal with the best of the best. That's why our people have all these great qualities about them, man. Yeah. You know, because the Lord, all right, established us as like gold upon the earth, man, which means we was valuable, man.
Right.
You know, look at all these empires and see how, at the end of the day, you had to rely on the Israelite man to really run their empire, man. Right. You know, showing you how valuable we are, man. Even when you go back to the Babylonian captivity, man. Darius was crying when he threw Daniel in the lion's den, man. Because he was bound by his word, you know, because your word was everything, man. Right. But he understood the value of that one man. You were king over all different countries, but you crying over one man, you know, showing you how valuable, all right, we were, man. Show you how valuable our people was, man, you know.
And look at how it's come out through the spirit. Luis Torres, I know that was a Jake, man. You know, so he helped Christopher Columbus, you know, come over here, navigate over here and speak to the so-called indigenous people over here, because they know, you know, he came out and said Torres, he spoke Hebrew, he was a so-called black man. So he was valuable to Christopher Columbus and those devils, man. Mm-hmm. Just like how all of us were in all these different captivities, just like the so-called Negroes, Latinos, Hispanics, Native Americans are valuable right now to Esau's empire.
Hey, I got one for you, Josh. Just real fast, Daniel 6:3. Then this Daniel was preferred above the presidents and princes because an excellent spirit was in him, and the king thought to set him over the whole realm.
Come.
When you go into that term excellent in Hebrew, it means preeminent and also extraordinary.
Extraordinary,
yeah, man. The Holy Spirit.
You know, their wisdom, that's divine, man. You know? But imagine a whole nation of people like that, man. A whole nation of Daniels, man. So Israel was a valuable nation upon earth, man. You know, via Yahweh Shemal Shai. You know, keep reading, bro.
He says, the stones of the sanctuary are poured out in the top of every street.
Mm-hmm.
He says, the precious sons of Zion, comparable to fine gold.
Yep. Okay.
How are they esteemed as earthen pitchers?
And how are they esteemed as earthen pitchers, man? So the Lord is comparing us in our glory, you know, as fine gold, you know, precious stones, all right, to us in this lower state is earthen pitchers, man. Who's really saying you ain't shit, man.
Right.
You know? And look at what we fell from. You got niggas killing each other over Jordans, all right, fighting over a pair of goddamn $5 shoes, you know, that Esau just marked the prices up on,
right.
You know, and over goddamn $4 chicken sandwich, man. All right? That's not us, man. So let's get some accounts of us in our splendor, man.
And then that's the beginning. And you wait the fucking Black Friday to get here.
Yeah, I was just thinking.
Dumb nigga that had thrown some goddamn chicken.
That's the same spirit.
Yeah, same spirit. They're gonna do shit in a couple weeks. Same shit.
Mm-hmm. You got it, bro.
Come on, this 1 Kings 4:21. And it says, and Solomon reigned over all kingdoms from the river unto the land of the Philistines, and unto the border of Egypt. They brought presents and served Solomon all the days of his life.
So this is the state that we was in. You see, Israel as a nation was on top. All right, because when you go into you know, what Solomon was ruling, that's all that land that they fighting over today, man. Solomon had ruled over it. So us as a nation, all right, we was in control of the traffic. You know, we had these heathens in captivity, man. You see, go ahead, bro.
Is Solomon's provision for one day was 30 measures of fine flour, mm-hmm, and 80 measures of meal,
yep,
10 fat oxen and 20 oxen out of the pastures, and 100 sheep, besides harts and roebucks and fallow deer and fatted fowl.
So this is King Solomon's daily provisions. Not saying that he ate all this himself, but that was for his household, man. His palace, his servants, all right? That's what they was eating on a daily basis, man. 20 oxen, man. All right, and you got a nigga fighting over a 1/4-pound piece of chicken, man.
Right.
Dying over a 1/4-pound piece of chicken, man. Yeah. You see, we had the best of the best, man. This was on a daily basis, man. You know, Jake threw, man. You know, the Lord has to step in and intervene, man. Cause I don't want to see what Jay gonna turn into, man. Or these women finna turn into, man. You know?
Mm-hmm. And you gonna see it all. Yeah. We got Jay Patrol, you know, things like that. Subject to us. I mean, they're subject to their prophecy, man. Mm-hmm. So these are not basically Israelites. These are actually niggas, man.
Yeah.
And no matter where you fall in on the chart, man, you're nothing but niggas if you're outside of the truth, man.
They're actually beasts, man.
They're beasts, bro.
Yeah, it's not called Babylon the Great for nothing, you know. Hence that word "great,"
yeah,
you know.
Yeah.
So it's gonna be you're gonna see a lot of crazy shit that you didn't expect to see in this society.
Mm-hmm. I got one to back up. Psalms 82:6. I have said, "Ye are gods, and all of you are sons of the Most High. But ye shall die like men and fall like one of the princes."
And that's how we feeling, man. You know, Yasha are the prince of the power, man. You know, when you go into the legacy of our forefathers to what we are today, man.
Mm-hmm.
You see, we're going to fail a long way, man. Yeah, this is ridiculous, man.
That's right.
You know, and it's just, like I say, it's just going to get worse, man. You know, so that's why, you know, Archangel Uriel will tell the Israel to pray for a few days, man.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that's what you need to be praying. Stop praying for these niggas. You pray for a few days, man.
Right.
You know? Yes.
Yeah, yes, sir. And it's Isaiah 5:20. Woe unto them that call evil good and good evil.
And people do that.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they think America, being in America, is good.
Yep.
You know, but when we tell them that they're Israelites, they call us evil. You know, they're in a fucked up state. It's a lot, they're in a fucked up mental state, man. Mm-hmm. You know, they lack the spirit, man. You know, because what separates us, you know what I'm saying, basically from the two-thirds is the Holy Spirit, man. We're the only consecrated ones, and that gift has been given to us by Yahweh Hashem Al-Shah. But everything we tell them that how they're going off in America, what do they say? They want to put us to death. Or mm-hmm. That's all you talk about.
Yeah, we say we better than the other nations.
Yeah.
You know, but they want to say that we all equal.
Right.
You know?
But really, when you talk about the other nations, the only thing they care about, only nation they care about is Esau. Right. They don't give a fuck about Moab, Ham, the Baham.
They want to put all hell on them.
Right.
They want to put all hell on us.
Yeah.
Just them to fix the slavery, though. That's the same spirit back then, you know. They just back them the same people, man.
Yeah.
They put darkness for light.
Right.
Life for dark.
Hey, and this world is totally in darkness, man. All right, this world basically thrives on a satanic vibration, man. All right, we're the only one that has the light, beginning with the apostles and Elder Achim, a great millstone.
Yeah, dark, you're kind of but just a line back.
Yeah, go ahead, bro.
Darkness for light. Y'all put the philosophies of Babylon on the pedestal,
right.
But light for darkness, you put the truth under a rock. You walk past us every week.
Every week.
You discard that, you make sure that doesn't go on the media. But the philosophies are saying, like you said, this was on the pedestal, mm-hmm. Man. Darkness for light.
Yeah.
Are they putting big up all these bullshit holidays coming up?
Yeah.
That's what's going to come up. You know they're doing it.
Mm-hmm. School to be thugs and niggas and homosexuals and adulterers and anything outside of the truth, they forward, man. They pull it.
And what is the way they hit you, they give Jake a culture that causes him to destroy himself, man.
Yeah.
All right, the whole concept of your mentality that you see Jake has, it causes you to ruin yourself. What does a single parent household produce?
Monsters.
So why do you subsidize it? If they know statistically that if she raised these little ones without the father in the household, the little girl gonna be a whore, the little boy gonna end up in prison. Why do they incentivize that?
Or faggot.
Why do they put the money behind that? Because the wicked watches over the righteous and seeking to slay them, man.
They put bitter for sweet and sweet for bitter.
Mm-hmm. You just gonna make a point.
Nah, because they know who we are, man. You know what I've been saying.
Yeah, Esau really trying to destroy us.
Yeah.
It's about the blessing,
yeah,
man.
Yeah, that blood.
Yeah, he wants that blessing, man. You know, because basically this world is not enough for the elite. No, they want the kingdom of heaven, man. You know,
yeah.
And so in order for them to get there in their carnal carnal mind, they think, okay, if we eradicate them off the face of the earth, then the Most High has no choice but to give us the blessing. Mm-hmm. You know, but then they'll teach the regular Edomites or, you know what I'm saying, these other nations, yeah, there's no Most High, there's no Yahweh, how shall look, they know on the left-hand side. Yeah. Just like the wicked spirits be fucking with us, the righteous spirits be fucking with them. Right. Each day they're telling them that their kingdom is at hand. Right.
That's why they turn up on the left-hand side.
Right. Right. That's why they're so mad. Yeah. Yeah. They ain't got them shooting you up when you get pulled over. You know what I'm saying? It ain't no such thing, no coincidence. But yeah, through the spirit, that's what's going on. You know, people, you know, when you don't know, you just don't know. So they just out here just being who you know what I'm saying? They part of the program, the script. It's still gonna go on, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. You still gotta play your part. It's just a blessing, man, to understand, you know what I'm saying? Just to know that it's deeper than this, man. We gonna go, it's a better place than this place. Just to walk around and don't know. Just remember how we were when we didn't know.
Yeah.
So now look back and be like, damn, man, I wish I could just go over there and wake Jake ass up, man. But I, you know what I'm saying? I can't do nothing bad. I can do just to tell them. And then, you know, and just keep on moving on, man. You know what I mean?
Yep. You know, and obviously, and then yesterday, that fucking voting shit.
Yeah, that shit is everybody.
That right there, people just, I voted.
That's stupid.
OJ came into the game yesterday. You know, he was feeling like his money worth, and he was going to say, he had a stupid ass sticker right here. He was saying, man, I'm trying to make a change.
Yeah.
You know, I ain't come back.
Right.
Yeah,
you like, all right, man.
Yeah.
Look who happened. Look who won.
Yeah. Shit, I don't even know.
Yeah, the Republican won.
Whoever they won.
And it's a video out on WAPT News, the local news channel down here. It says how it's a law in 130-year effect that says that black voters don't count. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. In Mississippi, though.
Yeah, you 3/5 of a human out in the country. You go out and vote, you just like taking one of them placebo.
That law is still a fit from 130 years ago, bro.
It's still fair in there.
Still
there.
They just like taking a placebo, what you call it, placebo, or fake pill, man. They just go out there, they just popping them bitches, go ahead, put in there, they like, that shit working, that shit ain't working.
I'm talking about niggas. They die for your right to vote.
Yeah.
Them niggas gonna die anyway.
Yeah.
Them niggas gonna be immortal if we vote, you know?
That's right. I got something for Ashley. I already said earlier about how the fits of slavery. This Isaiah 1:5, why should you be stricken anymore? You revolt more and more. The whole head is sick and the whole heart faint.
The whole head beginning with Judah,
right,
all the way down. Yeah.
From the ruler to the tomb.
You go from Easy E to Young Thug, man.
Yeah.
You know, you're going to get worse and worse. Why should you be stricken anymore?
Right.
You just evolving. That was the evolution to get Easy E. At least they were masculine back then.
Yeah.
They were masculine.
Yeah,
now,
right.
You niggas more wicked and now they're feminine, man.
Yeah.
You know?
Yep. It says, from the sole of the foot, even unto the head, there is no soundness in it.
Yeah, so from Judah all the way down to Issachar, man. All right, you know, our people don't know anything excluding the elect.
Mm-hmm.
All right? Because like the brother said, you know, prior to the truth, hey, we were just like that.
Right.
All
right.
Praise to Yahweh.
Right, you look back now, you be like, man.
Mm-hmm.
Be
more thankful and grateful.
Man. Yeah.
But wounds and bruises and putrefying sores.
Right. Where did that come from? Hey, the benefit of the curses, man.
What you always say, you know, generation.
Because we talk about the curses and things of that nature, but the only good thing about the curses is they are indicators of who we are today.
Right.
You know, so therefore we can go to Esau and say, look, according to biblical doctrine, mm-hmm. yo, this is us, and you cannot betray that.
The word putrefying.
Get Deuteronomy 28:44, bro.
Because it said putrefying sword, man. You know, that's a sword that everyone can see. Because everyone can see the sword within Israel, man. So-called Negro, Latino, Native American, man. You know? That's why your whole culture is a mockery, man. You know?
I think it goes to Torah. And it says fresh, new. Apparently meaning to be moist, properly dripping, hits flesh.
See, if it's moist, if it's dripping, it never heals.
Just like you got a sore.
It's dripping blue.
It's just like a sore, like when it first happened. It never healed. It's just getting worse and worse.
Hey, let me run out a quick thing. So, Jeremiah 30:12. But thus say Yahweh, thy bruise is incurable, and thy wound is grievous. And you know, that's the wound of the enemy. And that's the result of slavery, man.
Yep.
From the northern kingdom. Hey, that mentally ill.
Mm-hmm.
That they think they're better than us because they look more like their oppressor, which looks like their perception of their Messiah.
Yep.
Judas sick. Yeah. Judas is about the two both.
They both
for Hillary, you remember that? You know, that's an incurable wound.
That's right. And that's why you got that term called Stockholm Syndrome.
Yeah.
When the hostage has an alliance with the enemy or whatever, or they're oppressor.
Yeah.
We the hostages, man. So that's why you see on the video they showed not too long ago, Trump, he shook one Jake hand and the other tried to hug him. And Trump kind of just pushed his ass off. You know what I'm saying? They got that cool mentality, man.
That's Deuteronomy 28. When slavery was the emasculation of Jake, man.
Yeah.
I was just looking up the word humble, you know, but the result of slavery was to emasculate the nation of Israel. And the thing that separates Jake in America from Jake everywhere else, Jake in America don't know how to survive outside of Esau's existence, man.
Mm-hmm.
The thing that took your power away. You can't live on earth without Esau's existence, man.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
That's right. And you see it's right here. And putrefying sewers. So we're going to, I guess, like new. Mm-hmm. You know? It says they have not been closed.
Right.
So their mentality.
And the only way they're going to be closed is during the redemption period of Yahweh Shai.
Yeah.
Because you have to be spiritually saved from these curses, man.
Yep.
And that only comes with, and when Yahweh Shai returns, mm-hmm. man.
It says, neither bound up. So all these different so-called leaders of our people, all these speeches they try to present to our people, that's not going to bound our people up.
Right.
You know? Esau trying to get us, what's those things called? Reparations?
Yeah.
No, that's not going to bound us up as a people.
Yeah, because when we go into that term reparations, it means to restore or to put you back in your former state. Now, 40 acres and a mule is not going to do it.
This is just read by Solomon.
This is read by Solomon.
Solomon eat 20 oxen a day. You talking about 4 acres and 1 mirror?
Yep. And the mule don't do shit.
Yeah, he can't even reproduce himself.
Yeah.
So when they die, you do.
Yeah.
You back
one fucking mule.
Back to Walmart.
I can't see what Jake do with that mule. You know what I'm saying?
1 mule.
Jake don't eat that motherfucker. Yes, sir. Putrefying sores, they have not been closed, neither bound up. Need a mollifier with ointment.
Right, but the healing process starts with his truth.
Mm-hmm.
All right, being spiritually awoken. And then we wait for the physical redemption when Yahweh Shai returns.
Yeah, because on a spiritual level, like, you know what I'm saying? We spiritually, we got that soundness to us, but the rest of our nation don't. But in time that we all sick, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
That's why Yahweh Shai said in Malachi 4th chapter that he's going to come with healing in his wings.
That's right. Hey, Matthew 10:8, heal the sick, cleanse the lepers, raise the dead, cast out the devils. Freely ye have received, freely give, man.
And this truth is a never in the process of healing yourself.
Because
how can you come into this truth? That don't mean you just perfect. It's
just start the process.
You're starting the healing process, man.
Starting
to recover.
Putting that ornament on there.
Mm-hmm.
Like, boom, trying to get it right.
Mm-hmm.
You know
what I'm saying? This Philippians 1:6. Being confident in this very thing.
Hey, confident. Mm-hmm. We confident means with faith. We have faith in what? Go ahead, bro.
That he which had begun a good work in you will perform it unto the day of Yahweh Shai HaMashiach.
And that's what we waiting on, man. That's the only way. That's how we're literally going to awaken from this nightmare, bro. All right, but at the end of the day, we have to hold on, man.
Yeah.
And at the same time frame, if you are a prophet, hey, you need to be justified by your works and your faith.
Yeah.
All right, you need to be fervent in the truth, man. Doing your weekly videos, being out there on the highways and the byways, so on and so forth, man. All right, because at the end of the day, man, a judgment is coming to America, whether you believe or not. And a lot of our people are going to die. Especially you women, man.
Oh, man.
Y'all are going to get fucked up out here, man.
That's why your house shot, man, he's so important, man. Like, he's the man for real. Now, you think about the majority of our people are questioning what we say they're going to die, according to the scriptures. But he's doing justice for our people, man.
Oh, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Because he's going to get them out of that fucked up mentality that they in right now.
Spiritually,
yeah, those spiritual bruises and wounds that they have right now. That's why they're going to come back as a new person, man, in our new kingdom, man. You know?
And I got that word perform in the Greek, you know, because it said, you know, he that begun that work, that begun that good work in you will perform it until the day of Yahweh Shai. Because like the brother said, when you come into this truth, it's not the end all be all, it's the beginning process, man, of being healed, man. And we constantly, that's why it's important, you know, to continue to practice, you know, spiritual habits, man.
Yeah,
you know, and separate from this earth, man. Yeah. Separate from this world.
Man, it's beautiful. Because look, when the apostles, when they first came in, you know, like just the topic of health was important. You know, I'm going to say it wasn't important, but it wasn't pushed like on the vibration it is now.
No problem.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. So just look how, you know, brothers are still growing. They learning, man.
Yeah, because, hey, the spirit of that, hey, that's coming from your house, how we should eat, because that's a counter, that's a defense against the attacks of Satan. Because it tells you what, the word not ignorant of Satan's devices. And Satan's attacking the 12 tribes specifically through diet, man. And the way you get close to Yahweh by Shemal Shai is you detox from them chemicals, man.
Yeah.
And that puts you back. It's because you know the name, you're the truth.
Yeah.
That puts you back in tune with that spirit, man.
Mm-hmm.
We're naturally spiritual people.
Like Esau trying to give you all his vices to keep to continue to disconnect you from them.
And I'm going to say this right quick. You have to detox from your vices. With this, with anything that makes your mind cloudy, because Jake in the hood is a certain way for a reason, man. He's in a prison. He's in a concentration camp. And Esau is giving him these chemicals to keep him in a demonic state.
Like a rat in
the
lab.
Yeah, you're a rat in the laboratory. And when Jake drink that cheap liquor, Jake smoked the nicotine, the black and miles. You drive around listening to Gucci Mane all day. You smoking that weed. That's laboratory weed now. All right. You eat hot Cheetos. All right. That keeps you in a demonic state because it's all of it together affecting your one spirit, man.
You're part of the program.
That's
program. You know what I'm saying?
That's why people, when they exercise every day, all right, they change their diet. That's part of it, but you also got to pray.
Right.
You get a whole different spirit.
Oh, yeah, that's what Esau said. My auntie had called me a couple of weeks ago. She said on the news, Esau stated about exercise and basically can promote poor health.
Mm-hmm.
So all of this is disinformation to continue to get you fucked up because they know if they put it out there in the media and it comes on, projected from your TV, these ignorant motherfuckers don't believe it. Why? Right. Because it's coming from their gut.
And a lot of you, Jake, can somebody get there real quick? Because I don't want to just rant.
Yeah, Jake see some shit like that, man. I ain't doing no push-ups today, y'all.
Yeah, it's in your country.
It's
you go in a new day.
Oh, yeah.
It's a money thing. If you get sick,
it's a business.
That's what it is.
Because the gym membership ain't number $10 a month, $20 a month. But you going in and out the pharmaceutical industry because you sick. That's going to make them a whole lot more money, man.
Don't be surprised Esau started lifting those prices up in the gym.
Because
you see a lot of our people going to those gyms nowadays.
And this is Deuteronomy 28 and 29. And thou shalt grow at noonday as the blind gropeth in darkness.
Yeah, you should grow up in the noonday. Grope means you're searching.
Yeah.
But it says you do it in the noonday. That's why you're resorting to so-called religion. That's why you're resorting to comfort food, man. All right. And the reason why Jake out there hitting up new ports like that, because you're stressed.
Yeah,
The result of Babylon, this bitterness is stress, man. So hey, this truth is called a comforter for a reason, man.
Mm-hmm.
It's to comfort you from the stresses of the world, man. All right. And on a physical level, all that stuff you're doing to de-stress is killing you. Hey, start exercising, man. Esau's not going to tell you, but one of the top de-stresses is just exercising.
Right.
Go run.
Release all them endorphins.
Yeah, you release those endorphins, the serotonin, man.
It's a feel-good hormone. Feel-good hormone.
Feel-good hormones, man.
Yeah. Right. And thou shalt grope at noonday as the blind gropeth in darkness.
You looking for answers, man.
Yeah,
you looking for answers, man. I had a Jake approach me that I knew back in the day over 10 years ago. And he remembered me. He was like, hey, man, you still in the church. You know what I'm saying? And I was like, well, because I see you probably got your own religion and stuff. And but I thought about it. I was like, man, he probably looking for something.
Yeah,
for him to bring it up to me.
Yeah, yeah.
He was like, man, he tell me somebody needs to hear.
Yeah.
You know, but because Jake wrote it, man.
Yeah.
Yeah, in the noonday, the sun on that.
It's broad daylight.
Right.
That's
a
good point.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh,
man.
Noonday
is the highest point
where
the sun is shining.
Right. Because he saw God in the movies, what he's doing. You know, he got it in commercials. You know, it's all on the internet. The Lord got us on the internet, you know. So the light is shining bright, but Jake still got him blind, you know. But that's the curse of you. How about you, Mount Shasta?
Esau, tell you this is the information age, man. You can easily go to Google and you can find any type of thing you want to search for.
You can build a damn computer right now.
Three words. Origin of Christmas. Put it in Google, man. You're going to find out the origin of this shit that you've been celebrating your whole life, man.
Right.
Shut down.
You know?
You can read it and they'll still be like, they're going back
to the key.
And thou shalt not prosper in thy ways, and thou shalt be only oppressed and spoiled evermore, and no man shall save you.
It said, thou shalt not prosper in thy ways, man. That's why you're 50 years old still talking about entrepreneur ideas, man.
Yeah.
You know, no disrespect to brothers that have their enterprise, but in general, man, Jake is like 50 years old. And they still have these ideas of this get-rich-quick scheme.
Yeah.
Y'all should not prosper. All right, you've been working 20 years, and now the job is getting slow. The work is getting slow, and now you're thinking about another job, man. Mm-hmm. So here it is. Your work is to be broke, man.
That's right.
All right, you should prosper. How many rappers do you know or heard of that went broke, man? Right. Your favorite rappers from the 90s, early 2000s? Now they're broke, man. All right? You should not prosper in none of your ways, man. All right?
There's a more to that, bro.
They said no man should save thee.
They said no man should save thee. All right? Now, who? You think these leaders you have are the best, man? Nah, you could go back to Booker T. Washington, Marcus Garvey.
Right.
All right? You could go back to, I'm not even going to mention MLK and Malcolm X. You had actual men that had a pretty decent blueprint on how to help us in our situation. But we're in captivity, man.
Right. Who we got now, though? Who they got now? We got them. They ain't got nobody right now. No, they demonized so-called Jesse Jackson, Al Sharpton, all them just the ones that we was supposedly, you know what I'm saying, go to.
And them niggas on payroll.
Right.
Like, the closest thing we have to a leader is a damn rapper, man.
Yeah.
Leaders
for these niggas.
We got Jay-Z now. Yeah. You know he a damn warlock.
Yep. Hey, but that was the point, man. You still bring
that
to the
point, bro. Yeah. Come on. Let's go into that word in the Greek, you know, because how Shah said you're going to perform, you know, that work that he started in us. So you're going to take the word perform in the Greek.
2005.
Epitaleo. It says to bring to an end, to accomplish, perfect, to execute, to complete. Mm-hmm. So we're not going to be complete. Like the priest brought out, how shot gonna come with healing in his wings. You know, when we shed these vile bodies, all right, and get those glorified bodies, then we're gonna be complete. You know, but until then it's a work in progress, man. And you have to like the Quran is saying, you have to have something to counter yourself within Babylon, man. Because if you just continue to give your flesh over and obey your flesh, man, it's gonna consume you, man.
If you're not in this world right here, you're gonna lose.
Yeah.
If something else is keeping you from this realm right here,
right,
you're gonna lose, man. Because we're physically, spiritually, emotionally, financially under attack by Esau, man. And it's a demonic force. It's a demonic force in Babylon that's going in our, that's attacking our minds, you know, every step of the way. And if you don't have a force to counter that, like, you know, you got,
you're gonna be through.
You know how you got stones that counter dark energy?
Mm-hmm.
All right, you have to have this stone, which is Yahweh Shai. This is a stone made without heads.
Yeah.
You have to have that stone that counters demonic energy, man.
And then what happens, like, Jacob will get, you know, like, say, in the ego and think, you know, I'm strong enough. I got it. You know, but what happened, you know, say them demons lure you in, and then after a while, once you spiritually weak enough, they just gonna have their way, man. And they even show you every night that you ain't no competition for them. Yeah, well, they hold you down. I ain't met a testimony yet. Well, brother say he just been able to get. Yeah. How shocked. Yeah. Just tell the demon, all right, get off of him. But you got demon, get the rest of you too, man.
We're in a demon.
Yeah.
America is a demon, man. Which, when you go to work, you're driving through a demon. A demon has energy.
Yeah.
A demon has energy. It's a spirit. You're driving through a demonic force.
Right.
As soon as you wake up, you're in a demon. Right. Your computer, your TV, everything is emitting a demonic energy, man.
And well, who's the point? That's why when the babies come on up, they cry.
They cry, man. Right?
They're not at ease anymore. Why they fucking crying?
They got nothing to worry about.
Exactly. They don't know shit.
Brothers all brothers that have left the country. They all say when they come to America, they can feel a presence, they can feel energy. Then when they leave America, that energy is gone.
That shit concentrated here.
Yeah, it's concentrated here, man.
Right. Now, y'all show Isaiah 63 and 4. So the day of vengeance is in my heart, and the year of my redeem is come.
Yeah, the day of vengeance, man. You know, because the Lord has to avenge us because of how wrong we have been done within this system, within this society, man. You know, we're deprived of every damn thing, man. You know, this is the worst setup for an Israelite man in history, man.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know, because even in the other kingdoms, you know, you still can have multiple women.
Uh-huh.
You know, they want GMO on the food.
Right.
You know, you have all this just rampant, you know, homosexuality. Right. You had things going on back then. But this here is the worst, man. You know, because now your child is susceptible to these things.
Right.
You know, they can go on the phone and hit the wrong button. Now they, you know, watching gay porn or something.
This is worse
than it ever been, man. You know, a 7-year-old can say, I want to be a girl, you know, and then
they'll back this shit up.
You know, this is worse than it ever been, man. We need vengeance in this place, man.
Yeah.
All right, now I had a
change.
Oh, you were saying? Okay. You somebody this verse set up for.
I got one more. Daniel 9:12, and he have confirmed his words which he spake against us and against our judges that judge us by bringing upon us a great evil.
Man.
For under the whole heaven have not been done as have been done upon Jerusalem.
Hey, this is the worst beatdown of a nation in history, man. You know, because it's been just slow and just grinding and agonizing, man. You know, the repetition of you having to wake up in the same captivity over and over and over again, man.
Reincarnation. I'm in the control, but you're doing the same shit. Like, I'm looking at myself 3 or 4 Sundays ago. I'm literally doing the same shit. But then you have got Jay to go on vacation for 2 days and say, nigga, I've been 11 the whole time. But then when you get back from vacation, now you got to get overtime because you got to catch up with 2 days you missed.
We institutionalized in hell.
Yeah.
Jay is institutionalized in hell, man. You out of tune with the planet Earth.
Yeah.
It tells you how basically in Deuteronomy 28, we got to go through our enemy for all things.
Mm-hmm.
What about the planet Earth, man?
Right.
All right, can you get this definition right quick? All right,
I had one.
All right,
this is being objective.
You want the precept or definition?
I want a definition. You get the precept first, bro.
And this is Jay. Do I just Jeremiah 4:22? For my people are foolish; they have not known me. They are Scottish people.
They're Scottish people. You know, Salem is here, man. Scottish children, man. You know, and this is. Old people call God, man. This is him talking about the nation of Israel, all right, and how stupid they are, man. How stupid can you be, man?
That's right.
All right, life in prison over $4, man.
Yeah.
You know, that's crazy as hell, man.
That's why we're not pro-black.
Yeah.
we were focused on Israel, man. We don't claim you, man.
You go vote for us. You vote for a system that did nothing but oppression, man.
Christian,
right. You know? When you got to train your, especially if you got a little Israelite boy, all right, a little Jake boy, you got to train him, all right, about how to deal with the police if he pulled over. He's a whole different set of rules for this specific boy, when he get pulled over, than everybody else on planet Earth, but you still go vote.
Right.
You know? What the hell, what you doing, man?
Now, so they showed him raising Dina.
Yeah.
You remember how he was getting messed with the teacher?
Yep.
The principal, whatever that was?
Yep.
She said how, you know, if you look different than other people, they're going to treat you a certain way.
Yeah. When you're a jerk, man, you basically a lion that just walked in the room and everybody's afraid of you, man.
This little boy, like 7, 8 years old, you got to have a talk right there.
I know your history because I was watching a movie a couple weeks ago about Tay Diggs. He was a judge. He had married an Ammonite, so-called Japanese woman. But anyway, they killed his son, who was actually going to school to be a judge. And an Ammonite got married to Tay Diggs. She was like, because she was a police officer. So she quit her job. And she was like, how are you still a judge? You know what I'm saying? Okay, how are you still a judge and protecting the people that killed our son? She was like, what are you going to do about this? Dude just got killed driving while black in a nice car, waved at the guy. Oh, shit, he got a gun. Oh, no, he flipped me off. They pulled him over. They killed the boy, and they planted a gun on him. But that's the circumstances we go through being in America, man.
And no other nation goes through.
Yeah. And you know what? And
I say one more thing. And then we are, you know what I'm saying, and then we got a child coming of age. Shit, you afraid to let him go outside because he may not even come back.
See?
And you know, but that's why it says going back to Deuteronomy 28, that would say what does it say in Deuteronomy 28? Without the Most High, that it would day.
Yeah.
Without the Most High, is night.
Yeah.
All right, because basically, I remember when I was little, amongst a prayer, we made it back to the house. Like, thank you, Lord, we made it back to the house safely, man. Mm-hmm. All right, because when you leave the house, you might not come back.
Yeah. And then say, silence children going to these churches. Yeah. You know, ain't nobody figured out yet. Okay, the household, you might have 5 people in the household, so you got hundreds of years of going to church in one household, but don't nobody know nothing about the Bible, man. You know, you've been giving the pastor, the only one never heard for money. Everybody else in the band got to borrow from each other, congregation, but this nigga, the only one never heard for money.
He's switching our cars.
Yeah. You know, over the past 30 years, Elias Woman did a video, the black church been bought in $420 billion, man. You know, them niggas ain't built one apartment building, a subdivision, they ain't redid a driveway, a street,
man.
You know, but you niggas still go there 2-3 days out the week faithfully, singing and dancing and giving this nigga more money, man.
But you know who was the main people going to those churches? That woman, man.
Yeah.
Eve. But she's the head of the household now. So she blind, the whole house blind, man.
And JB chasing ass, so just to get the ass, they're going to do what the bitches do. Mm-hmm. You know, and then the scripture calls them foolish children, right?
Signs. No, I said, my people foolish.
Foolish. Foolish is what? Is an adjective. Going into the term fools, which means empty-headed. Mm-hmm. They don't have any wisdom, knowledge, and understanding of Yahweh Shem HaShem. So they're going to continue to be stuck in them churches if they are classified as the non-elect.
And all these churches, all these denominations, you would think, okay, we supposed to believe in one God. Why we just don't worship the same Heavenly Father then? Why we got all these different denominations, man?
Right.
People don't even consider just asking themselves like that. Why the white churches can't come along with the black church? You know, so why is the separation between them?
Yeah, the teachers a few years ago, the Edomite woman came from the church telling us to go back to Africa. Mm-hmm. Now, you just came from the church. Yeah. An interracial church and just told us to go back to Africa, man. Man, Jake wouldn't even consider that.
No, they don't.
And when the brother read about the, it's no great evil as John 20, as it did to Jerusalem, because I mean, I used to watch videos of the Israelite brothers, and then I'd be bringing that part up, how no other nation went to slavery like we did. And a lot of these, scorners, they'll be asking, like, well, the Chinese went to slavery. But as soon as you type in slavery on Google, you're going to see the so-called Negro, man.
Yeah.
You know? That's how it's already systematically, was officially designed for that to be. We're still in slavery, you see a so-called
people. We're still classified as slaves. Mm-hmm. To the other nations, we're slaves. We're captives. Mm-hmm. Like you tell an African that you're African, they'll be like, nah, we out of cod-picking Africans.
Right, right.
That stigma is still on us, man.
Yeah, and then Esau basically keeps you dumbed down through the process called denomination, man. You're Presbyterian, Protestant, or Baptist. When you go into that term denominate, it means to name completely. You are Israelites. You're not Baptist. You're not Presbyterian. All right, you're not fucking whatever you call these other branches, non-denominational. No, you are the Israelites if you're so-called Negroes, Hispanics, and Native American tribes, man.
And that whole concept is a branch of so-called Christianity, which is a branch of Roman Catholicism, man.
Branch of Edomite supremacy.
Yeah. Was a branch of Edomite supremacy, yeah.
All the so-called people who started those different denominations, they all Freemasons, man.
Exactly.
You can look them all up.
Yeah. Just to keep you blind, man.
Yeah. And they have no understanding. They are wise to do evil, but to do good. They have no knowledge.
Yeah, because y'all call good by basically, okay, I gave somebody $20 and they didn't get lunch. Or I let these people go across the street and I waited for them. No, that is not good. What Esau deems good in this society, that is not classified as good. Good comes from scriptures, man, and it's an action.
Yeah, you give somebody $20 that you systematically oppressing. Just understand, Esau is systematically oppressing you.
Yeah.
Like Wells Fargo had to pay over $150 million for systematically oppressing the Northern and Southern Kingdom. Yeah. For charging high interest rates for home buyers that were Israelites, man. All right, it's systematic oppression when they take the fathers out of the household, mm-hmm. the crack, the AIDS. Mm-hmm. All right, that's systematic oppression, man.
Vaccinations.
That bills they teach you in the school system, man.
Yeah.
That poor curriculum that doesn't prepare you for this world to live in. All right, that's systematic. That's systematic oppression.
So they wise to do evil, man. Mm-hmm. You know, Jake know how a thousand ways to steal, a thousand ways to commit adultery. All right, a thousand ways of murder. Another Jake. Mm-hmm. All right, they creative niggas that got. Creative in how to cook crack, all right, how to smuggle drugs, you know, how to celebrate these wicked holidays, but when it comes to anything righteous, Jake has no understanding of it, man.
Right.
You know, how to reverence the Sabbath according to the moon, man. You know, the Levitical diet, man.
Mm-hmm.
You know, understanding prophecy, man.
Mm-hmm.
Jake don't want no understanding that they won't understand the wickedness, man.
Yeah.
You know?
Quick point, y'all. It's a from insidehighred.com. It says this was published on April 12, 2019. Said Georgetown students vote to pay reparations. Then it goes down and says the measure calls for the university to start with a fee of $27.20 per semester in the fall of 2020 in honor of the 270 people sold by Georgetown, referring to the slaves sold by Jesuits who financed the university in its early days.
$27.20 per semester. I remember that. That was
a couple months ago. Yep. And it says the proposed fee would be a tiny fraction of the price of attending Georgetown, where tuition alone is more than $55,000 a year.
You see that? So Esau still fucks off, man.
And then Moab, on the interview, or little Moab, student, he was pissed off because he was like, "Why I gotta pay?" What he was mad. He was like, "Why I gotta pay this?" You know what I'm saying? Though he was pissed off because he had to pay the shit. He like, "I ain't did nothing, got no slave. I'm a Moabite anyway." You know?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, the hands tied into.
We're your number one consumer. Jake buying up all your PlayStations, all your iPhones,
mm-hmm.
right? We're making you a world power, man.
All these Chinese restaurants in the hoods.
Yeah, all these Chinese restaurants, they don't eat that crap, man.
Man, that ain't even real.
They're just chicken. Well, supposedly.
Nah,
Dog barking in the background. You order chicken.
I ain't them walking around. They getting everything moving with four legs on. They cooking and shit.
A lot of this shit be snake, man. Because in Rankin County a couple of years back, they had did a raid on the Chinese spot in Rankin County. And they opened up the freezer. They had a freezer full of snakes. Goddamn, what no chicken in that?
Also, they got caught with some dogs too.
With dogs and fucking snakes.
Yeah, they were bringing the dogs on already skin.
Yeah.
Out the van.
I seen it, man.
Yeah.
Rats and shit.
Where they had dropped it or something. Yeah, picked it up. They like, man, that's a dog, man.
Hey, stay away from all that BS, man.
All right, brother, say the last one. All right,
this Hebrews 14. Hebrews 13 and 14. It says, For here have we no continuous city, but we seek one to come.
And that's the righteous kingdom under Yahusha, man. You know, but we're not going to have to guess where food comes from. We're not going to have to worry about our children being trained and brought up in wickedness, man. You know, we're not going to have to worry about chemtrails, man. You know, Esau is going to be in complete subjection. Eventually, he's going to be done away with, man, and all these other heathen nations, man. You see, right, it's time for righteousness to flourish in the earth, man. Wickedness done had its run, man. You know, and our people, you got to get out this shit, man. You know, you still stuck in this matrix of America and continuing on and, you know, college funds and 401ks and, you know, trying to leave a legacy here, man. This place is out of here, man. You know, missiles are being prepared as we speak to take this place off the map, man. America would not be on the map, all right, when the kingdom of heaven set up on earth, man. You know, that's the time that we coming into, man. So it's time to separate, man, you know, and flee out of the midst of Babylon spiritually, man, you know. That was it, yeah.
Well, hey, with that, we hope you brothers are edified. And once again, we want to give our honor and glory to Yahweh, give honor to our apostles, a great millstone of well. Peace and blessings to the house of David, be elect. Till the next time, Shalom.
Shalom.